So the unseeded Chinese combination of Zhang Nan and Li Qinhui. Nearest to us getting this mixed doubles final underway. Sixth final here at the China Open for Zhang Nan. His fifth mixed doubles final. He was in the final of the men's doubles in 2010 with Chai Biao. Well, there's going to be a record set to whoever wins this on several counts, because so far this year all disciplines apart from mixed doubles have had a non-seeded pair win the title. So if the Chinese were to win, they'd be the first unseeded mixed doubles pair to win a mixed doubles super series title this year. If the Chinese pair win, of course, for only the ninth time in the history of the Super Series, we have the five titles going to players from five different nations. And if the Indonesians win, it will be the first time ever that China has not won a title in their, oh, that's clearly in their home event.
And then, no matter that Li Yunhui and Huang Dongping did well in women's doubles to reach the final, then I think the criticism will pop up again. The criticism that was popping up after the Olympics from, amongst others, Chai Yun.
Yes, former Olympic champion. Silver medalist in Beijing, and gold in London with Fu Haifeng. Is he involved in the coaching setup now, do you know?
I don't know, but I don't think so. If he was, it would be very, very uncommon to sort of voice his criticism.
Yeah.
I still think that even though they haven't won one of the first four categories, China, we've seen a lot of talent here, so it's not like I think we have to worry for the future of Chinese badminton, but
no,
there's some transition going on now in both women's doubles and women's singles, which have been dominated by China for a number of years.
Yeah. And I think that's a healthy situation for world badminton. You know, if you have a sport totally dominated by one nation, I'm thinking of women's archery, for instance. South Korea, totally dominant, aren't they, in that? And, you know, you don't have the same interest in the sport. Yeah. And when you've got various nations involved in the latter stages of tournaments, I think it's a healthy situation.
And it's also a sign that China, over the last 8-10 years, they've had some really, really legendary players. Legends are nowadays used on almost everything, but they are truly legends. I mean, Fu Haifeng, Chai Yun, men's doubles, Yu Yang, women's doubles. You don't have to mention Lin Dan and the others. So they've been so strong, and that makes it hard for the upcoming players to challenge them early enough.
Exact. Very, very good point.
And that means that you have perhaps half a generation that inadvertently are being held back by the big champions.
Yes.
And then at one point, the big champions, they're simply too old, they decide to retire, and it's very, very young players who have to take over.
Yeah. It's gone wide. But we were talking earlier, I can't remember which day it was, and And we were talking about these Chinese youngsters and indeed some of the Japanese and Korean players that, but more the Japanese and the Chinese players that they've been playing the Grand Prix Gold Circuit. They've been getting experience of winning.
Yeah.
And now they are getting the opportunities in the Super Series. And I mean, crikey, I mean, we can't be critical of China. They've been involved in four of the five finals.
Exactly. And I mean, it's also Wang Xishan. I mean, she's not that old.
No.
She's chosen to retire, whereas had she not retired, she would have been clearly one of the dominant Chinese players right now.
Yeah.
We've seen Wang Zhengmin in men's singles as one of these in-between generation players. And there were signs at the All England that Shui Song was on a really, really good track. He was playing really well at the All England, in my opinion. Suffered a tough injury.
In India.
Yeah.
Knee injury, I think.
And Chen Huwei has also shown some potential also in the All England. And then we see him here after the Olympics showing up with strappings on both his knees and so on. So injuries are something that can happen to anyone, and that will set you back. You don't just brush it away and go on to play on as if nothing had happened. So important to avoid injuries if you want to develop.
Yeah. Don't have to tell me about that, Steve.
No.
Now this is where I think Jiang Nan, now this is perfect from Jiang Nan. He noticed her body language, her inexperience. She was obviously beating up on herself, and he just calmly went up. We don't know what he said, but he seemed to be reassuring her.
But it's so difficult to play with Jiang Nan. Difficult. It could be easy because she's a very, very good player, but on a mental state, it's really difficult to play with him because, I mean, he's the former Olympic champion. He was absolutely dominant with Zhang Yunlei. So what if they lose this match? Whose fault is it? Is it Jiang Nan's? No, that's not the way she feels here. Li feels that if they lose this match, it's her fault.
Yeah, and that's how possibly some of our colleagues in the media or perhaps some of the fans will see it.
They could interpret it that way.
Exactly. So it's huge pressure on her to step into and fill the shoes of a player like Zhao Yunlei because they were totally dominant at one stage. Yeah, that's nice. I like that. It's difficult for her. Li Yunwei.
And they're playing the pair in the world that's caused the most trouble for Jiang Nan and Zhao Yunlei on big occasions because they've had other pairs that have good records against them, but not on the big occasions.
Mm.
But it says that
Gusev's fault called, struck above the waist.
It says a lot about Jiang Nan as a player. We saw him do well in men's doubles with Cha Biao. Quit men's doubles to focus on mixed doubles for the Olympics and won the title there. Was dominant in mixed doubles whenever needed in Sudirman Cup and won lots of Super Series tournaments. And suddenly took up men's doubles with Fu Haifeng.
Yeah.
Who was more or less expected to retire, but won an Olympic gold medal with Jiang Nan.
Yeah.
And now he's in the final with one of the Chinese youngsters again. That's a fantastic player.
Yeah. Well, there's certainly no doubt in my mind about Liliana Nasir to be world number one.
No.
With Nova Widianto, two world titles with him. The first female player to win three world titles in mixed doubles.
And it's not so easy to be a part of a world champion combination with two different partners. I mean, it has been done, but that's also primarily by the really, really great players.
Like your Park Jubongs.
Park Jubongs, Tony Gunawans.
Yeah.
Fu Haifeng. Though some might say that Fu Haifeng has had two really, really good partners, but
yeah.
Still,
yeah.
I mean, he's done his job.
Yeah, it's a common denominator there, isn't there?
Yeah. Tony Gunawan, Olympic medal with Olympic gold with Kendra Vijaya, and World Championships with Sigurd Buriatso and Halim Haryanto.
Yeah. Nice placement.
Yeah, he was caught recently for struck both waists.
Just asking for the court to be mopped. Umpire says, just scuff it away.
Look how far to the left Li Yinhui is standing.
That's good. You think that's obviously too far away.
I don't know. It's just that Jiang Nan he's got to cover that short forehand, I think, because I don't think she'll...
She can't reach it.
No, I don't think so. No, I think they have good reason for what they're doing.
Sub is over. 9:50.
There is no Hilary Anton. And Liliana Nasir won this title the first year it was a Super Series. Oh my goodness! That's an amazing shot, wasn't it? Look at this. How did he play that?
The Indonesians are queuing in the other corner.
Confident about that. That was closer than she perhaps realized. 16,
10. Yeah, she's got to learn on the fly here, Li Yinhui.
17, 10.
Yeah, look at her body language. I can tell you that once again Jiang Nan just walked along beside her as she was going back to her base position and was talking all the time, trying to reassure, trying to give advice and confidence. Oh.
11-17.
Double hit.
Yeah. He's been amazing when he's been under pressure in that deep forehand. Yes. He's won both rallies.
Service
ice block.
Oh, that was a good shot. I like that idea. Overdid it a little bit, but Jiang Nan, he was sort of crawling towards the side where Li Yunhui was standing, trying to help her out in the defense, and exactly that shot from Tuan Tovi Ahmad would have drawn him away from her again.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, take that. Very loose shot from Liliana Nasir. Talking to her, that's very, very good.
And I mean, it's so difficult to play the female role in mixed doubles, because a number of times you don't have anything to do.
Yeah.
Shuttles are flying fast past you, and then all of a sudden you have to be there.
Yeah, I agree. Well, first game point is converted.
First game, 21-13.
Just 17 minutes. I can very much relate to those comments you just made, Steve, about mixed doubles. I used to find that the whole time.
And it's almost when you then have actions. So. Jiang Nan and Li Yunhui on the presumably best side now. Let's see what they can do.
Oh, wow. Beautiful return of serve.
One left. I think Jiang Nan's upped his pace a little bit. More urgency to get behind the shuttle. Get it going in a downward direction. Oh,
Well, the really good thing would be if Li Yunhui turned around and said to Jiang Nan, hey, I'm not really playing that well, so you got to play a little bit better because otherwise we can't win this. And this actually, it's actually, I've heard one person do that. And the one that was being asked to up his game was the director of the BWF, Thomas Lund. And the one who asked him to do it was Pernille Dupont.
Oh, really?
So she was playing like crap. And then she turned around and said to him, hey, you got to play a little bit better because otherwise we're going to lose. So that's an alternative way of thinking.
Isn't she a high-flying solicitor now?
I think so.
Yeah. I think I was the one that finished her career. I was playing against her when she did her knee.
She got an injury.
Yeah, in Taipei. Could have been my flick serve as well.
Was it legal?
That must have been my partner.
Yeah.
The same shot. Oh, that was good interception. Definitely. Jiang Nan has indeed upped his game.
Aja. Naiknya jangan buru-buru nembak.
Service over. 4-7.
That's just long.
5-7.
Yeah, good return. Got the next board.
8-5.
Attack.
Service over. 6-8.
Notice Jiang Nan's serve is almost a bit like Fischer's serve. It's not a double forward movement, but he gets ready and then he seems to move it to the side and then serve. Clever placement of the smash.
I don't think that Jiang Nan and Li Yinghui can win this match by being that defensive. I mean, even Jiang Nan, Zhao and Lei had trouble when Ahmad and Natsir were attacking. Got to have the initiative, in my opinion. Well played.
Mm.
I have a feeling we are getting closer and closer to a situation where China is not winning a title on home soil.
Cross-court shots in that rally, wasn't it?
Also be the only category where we have an Olympic gold medalist winning. The Japanese women's doubles couldn't do it, neither could Marin nor Chen Long. Might only be one person if Jiang Nan and Li Yinghui wins, because he's won the men's doubles title at the Olympics.
In it, but the psychological effect of that on the Chinese youngster might be quite significant.
11-10. Play.
Gasp of disappointment from the fans.
And Jiang Nan was a little bit frustrated because he would easily could have played that one.
Beautiful block. And then disguise slice From Liliana Nasir. That really is brilliant. That's the block there. Well, we can't see it because we've only got half the picture in. Zhang Nan seems to have sort of tucked his long shorts up to be shorter shorts. We have an expression in English which is pulling your socks up when you need to improve. Maybe we'll have a new expression, pulling your shorts up or something.
That's when you have to improve a lot. Seems so easy. Look at him, let's see her. Just what Li Yinhui needs to get her game going. A couple of points lead. Sometimes when you're playing a new partnership and clearly with an experienced partner, there's so many things that you have to remember, and we play this way and so on. And thinking about your game too much often ends up in disrupting it.
Yeah.
So you can really be too much focused on what to do. I mean, it's got to be immediate. It's got to be without thinking that you act, because otherwise it's too slow.
Well, there's a challenge,
yeah.
And I thought that may have landed in. But I looked immediately at the line judge, and he spread his arms. Hang on, let's have a look. Oh no, it was out. It was out.
But close enough to warrant challenge, in my opinion.
Yeah, Hawkeye confirms.
Challenge unsuccessful.
One challenge remaining.
Service
over 40-50. It's a good serve. Yeah, that will help her confidence too.
Service over.
Now, I don't remember that heavy strapping on Liliana Nasir's right knee yesterday. I noticed the strapping on both of Tantoy Ahmad's knees.
Yeah.
Was it there?
I don't know. I was noticing it when the match began, but then I thought, well, isn't she normally playing with some sort of bandage on?
No, I don't think she does normally. Huh? No. That's good. Good pressure
74,
on the return of serve.
15-16.
This is the crucial phase.
Yeah.
Right now.
This is where we normally see Nasir excel. The Indonesians would cruise to victory.
18-15.
Treated to a third and deciding game. Oh. Oh. Yeah, got deflected badly.
Yeah.
Seven to the top of the take. 16-19.
Two fantastic services from Tantoy Ahmad.
18-19.
And what reactions there? Oh, just one point in it now. And the luck of the net caught.
Unbelievably lucky.
19-4.
And it's 19-all. Said she usually excels in these tight situations.
I didn't foresee that.
Who's going to have the game or match point? The answer is the Indonesians have a match point opportunity on a run of five straight points. My goodness me. Averted by the Chinese players. 20 all, extra points required until there's a clear 2-point winning margin. No service short. Service error. That's at least his second. So now, a second match point opportunity for the Olympic champions. What a good serve. It's one save though, isn't it? My goodness. To level this final at one game apiece. Opportunity. The backhand from Tuntui Ahmad. Well, there was a misunderstanding between the two Chinese players. The hesitation cost them dear.
Great prospects, no matter how this ends for China, because, I mean, are they compatible, Jiang Nan and Li Yunhui? Definitely. Can Li Yunhui get better? Of course she can. She will get better.
Yeah. So, 22 all. Opportunity for the Chinese to level this final. Flick serve?
No. Yes.
It's one game all.
Fantastic effort by Li and Jiang Nan.
Save two match points. Jiang Nan and Li Yunhui. And we will be treated to a third and deciding game. What a match. One game all. Different nations. Third and deciding game.
Oh.
bounced off the top of the tape. Steen, I think to put a fair perspective on things, I mean, we were talking about a transition period for China, and we've already made note of their youngsters that are coming up have stepped right into success in Super Series terms. But we ought to think about the World Junior Championships as well, that only concluded a week ago. Four titles going to China, so there isn't really a crisis as far as China badminton is concerned. But the other point I want to make is that in three of the disciplines at the World Junior Championships, the men's singles, women's singles and women's doubles, all four medals went to players from four different countries. So, you know, here we are at the China Open, where China has been dominating in the past. It's a healthy situation that there's more countries involved, you know, and that's going across the board. So there's no crisis as far as China is concerned, because the Junior World Championships says otherwise. But it is a healthy situation with the development of badminton.
That's exactly what Li Yongbo argumented when he was criticised a little bit for the Olympics. He said, hey, the other nations are stepping up, they're getting better.
Yeah.
And that's the way it is, and it's always tough to be number one, because everybody else is looking to see how can we challenge.
Yeah. Yes, that's a fabulous placement of the smash. And we have to be fair that an awful lot of nations have stepped up to the challenge by hiring and use of Chinese coaches.
Definitely.
We've done an awful lot of that in Europe. But it does mean badminton's in a healthy position right now. Great to see. Well, this is not the start that the Chinese pair wanted to this deciding game, is it? But is this the experience of the Olympic champions from Indonesia showing through? I wonder.
Yeah, I like the idea from Li Yongbo, because they got to control the rallies, Jiang Nan and Li Yongbo. They can play the flat game, that's fine, but I don't think they can afford to be too defensive against the Indonesians.
Oh, she stepped into that.
Fantastic. Some points soon. Jiangnan and Li Yongbo, otherwise the Indonesians running away with it.
Doesn't seem like much of a return of serve, but it's just perfect, isn't it? Because it's just in that downward direction and just enough pace on it to make it impossible for the net player to intercept, and yet there's nothing for the rear court player to feed off.
No. 3-8.
And he's going so much for it because it will be very hard for the Chinese pair to flick. And of course that's, in my opinion, what they should do. They should invest, but it's hard to invest when you're behind 8-3. What if he kills it, then it's 9-3, and it seems stupid to flick to Ahmad. But I think it's worth investing a few flick serves in sort of keeping him honest and not making him concentrate only on the net. Because there's a huge difference. I mean, if you can, you don't have to move ahead of the service being launched if you can concentrate 100% on the net.
Do you see that funny little movement that I've been talking about with his low serve going there?
Yeah.
It's odd, isn't it?
Yeah.
4-8.
And it's not easy to both serve in mixed doubles and men's doubles at the same time because it's two totally different positions.
Yes.
The shuttle's got to travel much longer distance here in mixed doubles. Those 4 points.
5-8.
4 out of the last 5 points.
When you're 7-1 or 1-7, depending on which side you're talking about, you think that it's a gulf, don't you? And all of a sudden, 6-8.
That was not a good service.
No.
And this is where your points, the odd flick serve, just to keep Tantoi Ahmad honest.
He's 98% going for the net.
Yeah. Advantage. as they change ends in this deciding game to the Olympic champions, Tantoy Ahmad and Liliana Nasir.
Play.
They've challenged. I thought that was... What did you think, Steve?
I think it was out.
Yeah, I thought it was out too.
Tantoy challenge for up.
Yeah, I thought that was out. But what does Hawkeye think? Ooh, Hawkeye says it was in.
Correction in.
That's also in.
Yeah, no question on that one.
13-7.
Well, once again, they have a 6-point advantage.
Closer to the goal now.
Gone wide.
Yeah.
There's another challenge.
Yeah.
Either need the point or the break.
No, I think it's out. Definitely out.
Yeah.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. 47.
Oh, he's been faulted once and he's played at least two service errors. Ahmad.
Slip away here. It's easy to get too confident. Got to buckle up now if they want to take this title.
Amazing defense from Liliana Nasir.
Service over, 60, 10.
Couldn't capitalize. What on earth? Well, she was off balance, but if she'd just played it anywhere across court, it would have been an outright winner. That's awfully easy for us sitting off court, isn't it?
And look at Jiang Nan's knee. The strapping is
hanging off.
Yeah, it's hanging off. It's sweating so much that it's come off. The arm as well. That is fantastic mixed play in the beginning of the rally where Jiang Nan is mixing it up between fast-paced flat shots and soft-paced blocks to the net, trying to get an opening. Fantastic play by this man here.
Another point there.
And most of the points for the Indonesians have come on errors from the Chinese pair. They're not getting it done in the rally play.
Yeah.
Nasir and Ahmad, they're relying on the Chinese going a little bit too much for the lines.
Shuttle keep coming back. Look at this.
Two. They had to kill it three times. She got everything back, Li Yinghui.
Absolutely amazing. Just 3 points needed for the Indonesians.
What an attack! Two jump smashes and then a rotation with her partner Jiang Nan. Sometimes badminton is an easy game.
Yeah.
That's experience.
Look at that. Delightful. Title here at the China Open for Ahmad and Nasir. Oh, she put that away with Ben. There's no way that was coming back.
She normally is very, very clinical on those shots there, but perhaps that was just what Li and Zhang needed.
Good flick serve.
Yeah,
but that's clever.
Seven forward.
And now match point opportunities once more. They had two in the second game, couldn't convert. They've got another four opportunities now. Oh, it's hit her. She tried to leave it. And the Olympic champions, Tuntui Ahmad and Liliana Nasir, win their second China Open title. 21-13, 22-24, 21-16 in the deciding game, in a match lasting an hour and 13 minutes. And with that victory, it does indeed mean that for the first time in the 30-year history of the China Open, China has not won a title at their home event. Well, my goodness me, who would have thought that at the start of the day when we looked at the order of players, we see confirmation.